Hello students, how are you all? Today let us continue from the trigonometry of the last class. There we have stopped at conversion of an angle. As you see here, 1 degree is equals to pi by 180 radians, and 1 radian is equals to 180 degrees by pi. We use these two formulas to convert angle in degrees to radians, angle in radians to degrees. Let me give one example to explain you that how we do over here. Please mind the class over here, because I will do only one or two questions. Based upon this, you have to do textbook sums, right? So convert the angle that is 40 degrees and 20 minutes into radians. Okay, this is a question. See how the procedure that I follow. Already I explained a little about this in the last class. 40 degrees 20 minutes I may write here. Between them spaces, their space will tell you that plus 40 degrees plus 20 minutes, like this, and keep 40 degrees as it is. 20 minutes you convert into degrees, so that a degree, we can utilize 1 degree is equals to pi by 180 radians. So 1 minute is equals to what? 1 by 60th of a degree, right? If you write degrees here, so power degree is the same as 1 degree, so that you can cancel here. 21 is 20, 3 is a. So if you take degrees here and here common, so what you'll get then? 40 plus 1 by 3 times of degrees you will get into 1 degree. It means into 1 degree. If you simplify inside the open bracket, that is 121 by 3 into 1 degree. Power 1 degree or into 1 degree, both are same only, I'm telling you. Okay. So 121 by 3, 1 degree. Now you need to apply that formula, conversion formula, degrees to radians. 1 degree is equals to pi by 180 radians, or into 1 radian, both are same. Okay. If you want to simplify, you simplify. But whenever you are converting angle, angle which is in degrees to the radians, okay, final answer will be in pi. Final answer will be in terms of pi. You no need to simplify into decimals. So pi means what here? You can keep it, I hope, as it is. It is 121, right? 121 pi divided by 18, 3 is how much? It is 54. So this these many radians is equals to 40 degrees and 20 minutes. This is your answer. Remember one more thing I'm telling you: whenever the angle is in degrees, when you convert it into radians, answer will be in terms of pi. Don't simplify much over there. But conversion of radians into degrees will take the time. You need to do a lot in that whenever improper fraction comes. Another example let me have to explain. Now we do example for radians to degrees. Convert the angle 1 by 3 radians into degrees. This is your question. Answer or solution to that: take 1 by 3 radians he has given you, right? Do one thing. 1 by 3 radians means 1 by 3 into 1 radian. Now in this 1 radian formula, in terms of degree, we can write here, that is 180 by pi degrees. Pi degrees if I keep, or 1 degree if I keep, it both are same only. If you have to simplify here, how much you can. So you can see here 3 ones are. How much it is? 360s are. And then still you can simplify. 60 divided by 22 by 7, so into 1 degree you can write here, right? 2 table 11s are, okay, 2 30s are, you will get into 1 degree. Anyhow, we have now 120 divided by 11 into 1 degree, or power 1 degree, both are same. Now see, this number is in improper fraction. You have to simplify into proper. So divide by, in 11 table you try to divide it. 11 ones are, how much it will be now? 11 twos are 22. So you cannot take 22 now. 11 ones are now 11, means 10 will be left over. 0 when you add here 100, then 100 means 99s are. Okay, 9s are, 11 9s are. So 11 9s are 99, it was 100. When you subtract, you will get 1. So that 1 will be become the remainder, right? Using division algorithm, like I taught in the last class, that 1 is a remainder, okay? And 11 is a divisor, 19 is what you know, quotient, by which you will get here. Dividend is 210. So into 1 degrees. Now do one thing, multiply this degrees to this one and this term. So you will get here 19 degrees and 1 by 11. What is that? Degrees again. That 1 degree you can write in terms of minutes. 1 degree is equals to 60 minutes. 60 minutes means 60 into 1 minute. So when you are converting into degrees, the answer will be in terms of degrees, minutes and seconds. Okay, so 19 degrees in degrees over. Now we are converting into minutes. Another part of 1 by 11 we are converting into minutes. How much it will be? 60 by 11. 60 by 11, if you simplify, 11 ones are, 11 fives are 55, means 5 left there, right? Therefore that 5 will be become what here, remainder. 5 by 11, there is nothing to add over there. So this will become into 1 minute, right? Because 1 minute is multiplied here. So 19 degrees plus, multiply this 1 minute to this, also to this, 5 minutes plus 5 by 11 seconds into 1 second, sorry, into 1 minute, into 1 minute. We are multiplying minute to the 5 by 11, also to 5. So into 1 minute is there, 1 minute means you what, 60 seconds. Now that one also you can simplify, like 19 degrees plus 5 minutes. How much it is? 6 5 is 30, that is 300 divided by 11 seconds, it is there, right? Now you try to simplify this one too. 11 ones are, 11 twos are 22, means it is 30 here, 8, right? So 8, if you take it 0, 80, 80 in the sense 7 is 77, so you will get 3 the remainder, right? So 3 you will get, and if you put the decimal point over there, 30, 30 means how much it is? 2 is 22, again you will get 8, 8 in the sense that is, if I put all the decimal is there, that is 0. Then 7 is a decimal if you get it. So total I can say that 19 degrees plus 5 minutes plus 27.27, that is seconds. Okay, converting radians into degrees will involve degrees, minutes and seconds. So according to the answers you can check it out which is correct answer. If you want to write here without plus, 19 degrees some space, 5 minutes some space, 27.27, still it will recur, okay? So you can say approximately, because fully I didn't calculate, approximately you can say, right? This is your answer. So it's very important to convert radians into degrees. Next, another question let me give you. 5 pi by 12, convert into radians, sorry, into degrees. It is in radians, you convert into degrees. This is another question and the solution of it if you want. So you take again here 5 pi by 12 radians, right? Radians means into 1 radian. 5 pi by 12, 1 radian means what here? 180 by pi degrees into 1 degree you can write here. This pi will go, can simplify still here, all right? So this is like 6 2s are 6, 30s are 2 1s are, and then it is 15s are. 15 5s are, that is 75 into 1 degree, 75 degrees. So I could say that 5 pi by 12 radians is equals to 75 degrees. Here y degrees hasn't converted into minutes and seconds, sir, means there is no fractional part to convert into minutes. As you look here in the last problem, after you converted into 19 degrees and 1 by 11 degrees, 1 by 11 degrees is a fractional degrees, fractional part of degrees. That fractional degrees you can convert into improper, that's a minute and seconds like this. How we converted into minutes? By putting 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes, and 6 minutes are converted into seconds. In such way, whenever fractional part will come, after whole part has come, okay, you can convert into minutes and seconds. But here no fractional part has left in 75 degrees. Directly we have like a whole part 75 degrees, therefore we leave it as it is. Okay, this is very important procedure to follow for finding the problems from radians to degrees. And degrees to radians, anyhow, it will involve in terms of pi. Just putting this 1 degree is equal to pi by 180 radians and normal multiplication and leaving as it is, right? So this is what the problems. So I may share you the trigonometry chapter of NCERT textbook. You can practice from there the questions. So after this one, we have another question, some problems, we do some applications upon it. Next one problem, that is the sum of two angles is 5 pi radians. The sum of two angles, applications upon radians to degrees, degrees to radians, upon the angles only application. Sum of two angles is 5 pi radians and their difference is 60 degrees, and their difference is 60 degrees. Okay, then what is asking? Then find the angles in degrees. Then find the angles. See how the applications we have using or upon angles in trigonometry. Find the angles in degrees, right? So in solution, sum of two angles is 5 pi radians and their difference of two angles is 60 degrees he has given. Let whatever the two angles he is telling in the question, let those two angles be some x and y, right? So let the required angles be x and y. You have to write the words, I'm not writing. Let the required angles be x comma y. Then according to the question, x plus 5 is equals to 5 pi radians and their difference x minus y is equals to 60 degrees. You get x and y by elimination method. If you simplify, 2x is equals to 5 pi radians plus 60 degrees. Therefore x is equals to 60 degrees plus, I'm writing 60 degrees plus first, and 5 pi. Pi radians means what here? I told you already, pi radians means 180 degrees. Phi is a constant, you can write outside. See, 5 pi radians is fully in radians, but phi is a number, anyhow radians have taken off. So into pi radians. Pi radians means what here? 180 degrees, totally it will become in degrees, divided by 2. So how much then? 60 degrees plus 18 phi is, that is 90. So 900 divided by 2. Here you can say that 960 degrees by 2. What is 960 in degrees? 960 divided degrees by 2, half of this 960. So I can say here 30 and then 450, right? So 450 plus 30, it will become 4. Right, 450 plus 30, it will become 480. This is half of that. If you simplify also, you get the same, right? And then x I found. What is x in degrees? 480 degrees, right? What is y then? Keep in this second equation to get y in degrees. Therefore, from there y is equals to you can say that x minus 60 degrees. So that is 480 minus 60 degrees. Okay, how much it is? It will be 420 degrees. So x and y we found in terms of degrees, that is 480 degrees and 420 degrees. Okay, this is your question. And then okay, you understood right how the questions were doing in that applications in trigonometry. Next, let us do one more question. In a circle of diameter 40 centimeters, next problem. In a circle of diameter 40 centimeters, the length of a chord is 20 centimeters. Okay, find the angle of a minor arc corresponding to the chord. Find the length of a minor arc corresponding to the chord. Understood anything in the question? If you want to understand anything, no problem in that. In a circle of diameter, there is a circle you need to draw. Okay, diameter 40 means radius, how much it will be? 20 centimeters is radius. Okay, and the length of a chord is 20. Let's take one chord. This will be chord AB, I'm telling, whose length is again 20. If you join again center with this another point of the chord AB, okay, again you will get 20. You are getting a right triangle ABC there, where C is the center of the circle. Find the length of a minor arc corresponding to the chord. What is the minor arc corresponding to the chord? That is what? AB is a chord over there. So this is the chord, right? Which is corresponding, which is the arc, minor arc, sorry, which is the minor arc corresponding to the chord AB, right? So major arc corresponding to the chord AB means this another part, this total part will be the, apart from this AB will be another part is major arc, whose length, AB length, you need to find out. Okay, now as you see here, ABC is a equilateral triangle over there, so that all sides are same there. Therefore angle, the center angle will be what then? Angle C, it will become here 60 degrees, right? So right, angle C is equals to what here? 60 degrees we found. And you can say this is a theta, right? And that too, here you need to find length of AB, right? And radius is known here. What is the radius? 20 centimeters is given. Okay, and okay, is asking length L. See, we have a formula. What was the formula? When arc length L subtends theta angle at the center of the circle with radius r, then what is the formula? L by r is equal to theta. Arc length of L subtends theta angle at the center of the circle, then L by r is equal to what? Theta. This is a formula given you in the last class. Please check it. Very, very important formula. From here, you need L. No? L is equal to r cos theta. R is what? 20 centimeters. And theta in degrees, but L is length, it has to be in centimeters, should not include degrees over there. So do one thing here, as a L is length, length is always a real number, so degrees should not include in the length. Means you need to convert degrees into radians. Radians is a real number only, no issues. So 60 degrees, 16 to 1 degree, 1 degree in terms of radians, that is pi by 180 radians you will get. So if you simplify here, 1's a 3's a, right? You can say here 20 pi by 3 radians. Pi by 3 radians, if I won't keep, it won't be angle, right? Even if I won't spell, it won't be angle, it will be a real number, that will be a length, right? So 2 pi by 3 is, you know, the length of the minor arc which subtends 60 degrees at the central angle of the radius, central angle of the circle whose radius is 20 centimeters. So your answer is this one. Next question, let me explain you. Such word problems also you have in NCERT textbook, there you can try. Next, in a circle of 5 centimeters, in the circle of 5 centimeters radius, in the circle of 5 centimeters radius, what is the length of the arc? What is the length of the arc which subtends an angle which subtends an angle 33 degrees 15 minutes 33 degrees 15 minutes at the center center. So according to this question, if you want the solution to this, see over here, in the circle of 5 centimeters radius, draw the circle here, right? 5 centimeters radius, this is 5 centimeters radius, okay? What is the length of the arc which subtends an angle? Let us consider one arc AB. Let us consider one arc which subtends, he is telling, this is angle theta. The theta giving here 33 degrees 15 minutes he has given. So arc AB subtending at the center C 33 degrees 15 minutes, okay? So what is the length of that AB? Here given things are here, angle subtended by the arc length AB, okay? Let us consider arc length is equals to L, that you need to find, and radius he has given, that is 5. Use the same formula, therefore L by R is equals to theta, which implies L equals to R cos theta. R means what here? L is equals to R theta. What is the theta here? 33 degrees, right? Plus 15 minutes. 15 minutes means 1 minute, that is 1 by 60th of a degree, you can say in this even. So this is outside of it, and if you simplify this inside, that is 33 degrees plus how much it is, 15 ones are 15 fours are, therefore 1 by 4 degrees will get here. If you simplify, how much it is, 120 plus 12, 120 plus 12, 132 plus 1, that is 133 divided by 4. These many degrees will get here. But your answer must not be in terms of degrees. Why? Because it is a length. Length must be in terms of radians. So then only it will be correct then. I can say from here 123 by 4 into 1 degree. 1 degree in terms of radians, that is pi by 180. Radians, if you don't keep radians, or if you keep it as it is, no problem, right? So this will be your answer. If you can simplify, you can, right? So how much it is? 5 ones are 5, 3 is 15, it is 3, 5, 6 is 30. And still, if you can, you can keep it, or else you can write as it is. That is 133 pi divided by 4 into that 36 in the down, 24 to there 12, that is 14 into 1 radian, 144 into 1 radian. No need to write that radian, you can write it centimeters, but because it is length. If it is an angle, I can say radians. If it is a length, I may say centimeters. So this is your final answer from here, right? Let me have one more question to explain you. The minute hand of a watch is 35 centimeters long. Next question here. The minute hand of a watch is 35 centimeters long. How far does its tip moves in 18 minutes? This is your question. Okay, see the solution of it. We'll take a red color in this. What he is giving you? The minute hand of a watch is 35 centimeters long. Let us consider this is a watch in a circle type. Let us consider this is a minute hand whose length is what here? 35 centimeters. Here the center of the watch, you can say, as a circle. Now we know very well that in 1 hour, in a sense, in 60 minutes, okay, in 60 minutes, the minute hand moves, how long it is, minute hand moves, the length will be equal to circumference of the circle, that is 2 pi r, right? Where r is what here? The length of the minute hand. So I can say that in 60 minutes, the minute hand travels or moves 2 pi into 35 centimeters. This much of distance it will travel in 60 minutes, right? So in 1 minute, I could say that in 1 minute, the minute hand will travel or move 35 by 60. 2 pi into 35 by 60 centimeters it will travel. Okay, so, and in 18 minutes is asking, you can say that in 18 minutes how much it will travel. If you multiply 18 over here, 18 into 2 pi into 35 by 60 into this much of distance it will travel, right? So if you simplify here, you will get the answer in 18 minutes how long the tip is moved, or the minute hand has been moved. Okay, you can simplify here to ones, that is 30s, right? Then you can say here 18 means 6 table, 3s, 6 5s, 5 ones, 5 sevens, right? So how much it will be then? This will be equals to, you can say 7 3s, that is 21 pi. 21 into pi left over there, you see here, not being cancelled. So 21 pi centimeters it will travel. What? In 18 minutes, the tip of the minute hand will travel 21 pi centimeters. That is your answer. And then if you want, pi also can be simplified, that you can say that 22 by 7. Still, if you want to simplify, you can simplify, or you can leave it as it is. 22 by 7, 7 ones are, 7 threes are, therefore it is 66 centimeters it will move. That is your answer for that. And then one more question. Let me explain in this if time is there. Okay. Okay, then I'll explain in the next class. Time is not that much. Or else we can do, it doesn't matter. Question. The wheel of a railway carriage. The wheel of a railway carriage is 40 centimeters. 40 centimeters in diameter. In diameter. So radius of the wheel you can consider that is 20 centimeters from there, and the wheel makes 6 revolutions in 1 second. 6 revolutions in 1 second, right? Then question is, how fast is the train is going? How fast? How fast means what speed, right? How fast is the train is going? This is your question. Solution. The wheel of a railway carriage, you can say that it's a circle. Circle itself, it is a wheel. So whose radius, what here, 20 centimeters he has given. Okay, diameter 20 means radius will be 20. 6 revolutions in 1 second, right? So we'll make 6 revolutions in 1 second he has given. How fast the train is going, and how fast in the sense per second, how much distance it is traveling, that I need here, right? Per second, how much distance it is traveling, I need to find it here. So I could say that here, in 1 revolution, how far the train will move in 1 revolution. In 1 revolution, it will move 2 pi r length. 2 pi r means equal to circumference, right? So train will move equal to 2 pi r length in 1 revolution. So I can say that in one revolution, so train will move how much length it will move? 2 pi r. What is the radius here? 20. That will be equals to 40 pi centimeters the train will move in 1 revolution, means in 1 complete rotation of a wheel. So in 6 revolutions it will make 1 second, it is telling, right? So I can say that what about in 6 revolutions? So I can say that in 1 revolution it is moving 45 centimeters in the sense. In six revolutions, it will move 6 times of 40 pi. Yes or no? 6 times of that 40 pi. That in the sense, 240 pi centimeters the train will move in 6 revolutions. Right, right. So I can say that what is the speed now? Generally, speed means what here? Speed in the sense of distance. Per time, distance by time. So I can say that 240 pi centimeters it will travel, you know, per second. Why it is per second? We are calculating the distance. Distance is 240 centimeters. We have calculated in six revolutions, and in 6 revolutions will happen by the wheel in 1 second. Means we are calculating the speed per 1 second. So per 1 second, how much distance it is being traveled? 240 pi centimeters it is being traveled. So I can say that the speed of the train is 240 pi centimeters per second, you can say it. Okay, this is your answer. So by this I am closing this subtopic, that is problems upon the degrees to radians and radians to degrees. Okay. The next class I may start with another topic of trigonometry. Please do read well and ask the doubts. You can solve the problems in the NCERT textbook that I share in the group, right? Okay. Thank you then. Let me close the class here.